Here we have verse 6 of the 8th chapter of the Gospel of John. We're in the midst of that highly dramatic moment in which some religious leaders have apprehended a woman who allegedly was caught in the very act of committing adultery. They've drugged her unceremoniously into the temple precincts where Jesus is carrying on a teaching ministry there with people who've gathered. It's in the morning. And they parade this woman in front of the crowd and in front of Jesus. And of course, their interest is really very little related to the woman. They're not even that interested in the character of what the law demands. They're simply interested in embarrassing Jesus. Jesus has been getting increasing traction, popularity, and in a sense, they're feeling that he is outshining them, you might say, in the devotion he has to the law and to the integrity of his public discourses and so on. And so they're just trying to find some way to sabotage him. And that's what this entire story is about. And so we have, beginning in verse 6, then tuto, demonstrative pronoun. This is the accusative, singular, neuter. It's the direct object of elegon. So, lego, I say, this is the third person plural, imperfect active indicative. So they were saying, tuto, this, postpositive, duh, but they were saying this, pyrodzontes, from pyrodzo, it means I test, as in putting someone to a test of some kind. It can also carry the idea of I tempt someone, trying to seduce them. The word can have both ideas to it. This is a masculine singular nominative participle. It's present, so it actually goes with the subject of the verb. So they, testing him, auton, the object of this verb, the third person singular, accusative, masculine pronoun. So they were saying this, testing him. And so that's the first thought in this statement. So they are saying these things, their intention is to test him, they're putting him to the test. Hina, in order that, normally takes the subjunctive as we have it here, ekousen. This is from echo, I have. This is the third person plural, present active subjunctive, so in order to have. And then kategorein, this is actually an infinitive. From the verb categoreo, it means to categorize something. We have that English word from this particular word, but actually the sense of it was to accuse somebody by putting them into some sort of a category by which their guilt could be defined. So they wanted to have, and then the infinitive of that, to accuse him, or some basis is the sense of it, to accuse him. Categoreo takes the genitive, and so we have the genitive pronoun here. So they were saying this not because of any interest in the woman or any such thing, but simply they wanted to have a basis upon which they could bring accusations against him. Ho, the, postpositive da, but the Jesus, literally, but Jesus. Kato, this is an indeclinable adverb. It's related to the preposition kata, which means down, so this would be an adverbial form of that. There's no such English word, but we might render it sort of descriptively downly. He's doing something in a downward fashion. What's he doing? Well, it's kupsos. This is from kupto, to lean over, to bend over. That's the idea of it. This happens to be the masculine singular nominative participle, the aorist participle. So Jesus stoops over in a downward fashion. So leaned over, stooped over would be the idea of it. And then toe, the dative singular masculine article, toe doctulo. This is from doctulos, which means a finger. It's in the dative. We call it the dative of means. And so he leans over in a downward fashion by means of the finger, and then kategraphen. The word grapho means to write. Katagrapho means to write down. This is the imperfect of that, so it's the third person singular imperfect active indicative. So by means of the finger, he was writing down ace, preposition takes the accusative, tain, gain, into the earth. The word gain there is actually the word gay, which means earth. We get the word geo from that. It's somewhat misleading because it's often translated earth, but it doesn't mean earth in the modern sense of the word as in a planet, you know. It means earth as in something more on the order of the good earth, the dirt, the land, the field. And that's the way it's consistently used in the New Testament. It's especially important in Revelation, I might mention, because there's frequent mention to the earth, and people tend to misunderstand the significance of the phrase because it's actually, as is in view here, to be referring simply to the earth as in the dirt, you know, the land or something like that. So Jesus is writing with his finger in the earth while these people are raising these questions to him, trying to categorize him, trying to accuse him, trying to find some basis upon which they can find fault with him and thus embarrass him and reinstate their own reputation in the popular understanding.